The following is the sixth grade lesson for January 31st, 2017. A few reminders to start us off. Spelling words are due on Friday, 35 times each for wrong answers. Make sure you're studying every day, okay? Your next test is going to be a week from Friday. Your reading log is also due on Friday, okay? If you did not get your spelling words, make sure you get them from me so you can get them finished. Your AR alternate assignment is due tonight at midnight. Make sure you're getting that done, okay? We also have a new student teacher, an intern that's going to be helping us out for this semester. If you were absent, his name is Mr. Foisey. Make sure you introduce yourself when you see him in class, okay? All right, we're going to go over all the causes that we've missed the last few days, okay? So you're going to see them, then I'm going to basically give you the answers here, okay, while explaining what everything's doing. So William Waggish, Pauline, Mr. Math Martinet, and then Wrathful Math, those should all be capitalized. Faint should be capitalized as well, okay? So you need commas after Waggish and Pauline, after limericks, and after ears and fluttered. Two, the word T-O-O needs to be separated from the sentence, always, 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 okay? In the first sentence, worried about Pauline, that's kind of giving you a detail about William Waggish. Since it's a detail that can technically be taken out of the sentence and it's still a sentence, it needs to be separated by commas, okay? And then, again, we're getting more details later on. This one about a malevolent math teacher in town with wrathful math, that's talking about the limerick, okay? Which is unimitatable, which means it's difficult to, it's unique, hard to copy. That's what inimitable means, okay? So he's writing his poem, his limerick, about his math teacher, and he called it Wrathful Math. Since it has a title, it should be in quotation marks and capitalized. Okay. And then, obviously, we have one of the more, we have more of those unusual names with Mr. Math Martinet. Okay. Then malevolent means hateful, evil, intending to cause harm. If you've ever seen Disney's Sleeping Beauty, you might know of a character named Maleficent. That's where she gets her name from, because she's very malevolent. And wrathful means angry, full of wrath. Wrath is, well, anger. Alright, for number 30, or indenting it since it's a new idea. So at this, you're going to put a comma after it, because that's intro. So put a comma after it. Could have heard a pin drop as the students' mouths gaped open at their peers' boldness and their teachers' antics. Now, I forgot to correct this one here, but that first there should be T-H-E-I-R. Okay. So, actually, I could probably do that right now, while I'm thinking about it. So let me get to that screen. There we go. So, could say that I got caught on that one. Alright, so that's how it should look. Okay, their teacher's antics. A lot of apostrophes here, okay? So, students, they're talking about multiple students, all the students in the room. So, you have the apostrophe after the S. For peers and teachers, it's just one, so they're going to have apostrophe before the S. Okay, for the next sentence, Williams, well, only one William, so apostrophe S there. Okay. And here's what the words mean. Peers are others your age, not necessarily friends, but others in your age group or others that you normally associate with. Okay, demise means death. And the uncompromising is not willing to change. So, number 31, some exclamation points in there, another indention, because it's a new idea, okay, and this one was pretty easy. So, resumed is continued, emitting is giving off something, usually a sound, or smoke, or something like that. Number 32, okay, similar idea, so it's still talking about Mr. Math class, okay. So, that's going to keep everything in there so that first section does not need to be indented, okay? The second part, though, is a different idea. So, that's why that sentence is indented. And again, there's multiple students, so the apostrophe goes after the S. Pandemonium is craziness, chaos, okay? And number 33, similar idea as the last sentence from number 32. So, it's not going to be indented. Okay, a lot of capitalization and a lot of commas. You have a lot of lists here. Okay, so make sure that you are getting all of those in. And intrepid means exploratory, brave, bold, stuff like that. Amicable is agreeable or friendly. Melodious is musically pleasing or anything involving music to the ear. Okay? Other than that, we basically just went to the book fair, and that concludes the lesson of the day.